Welcome. I'm Joseph Mooney, and I'll be your master of ceremonies. At this time, we will salute the flag. Gentlemen, please remove your caps. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I would now like to introduce our guests for graduation. Mayor Boughton, Board Chair Cooper, present and past members of the Board of Education, Superintendent Pasquarella, Assistant Superintendent Walston, and the rest of the members of the Cabinet. It's quite unique to meet you all under these circumstances, but as we've all found out, 2020 isn't the most normal year. You're likely watching this whole graduation on a screen of some sort, but don't allow that to retract from the occasion that is graduation. I would like to introduce the Mayor of Danbury, Connecticut, Mayor Mark Boughton.
Dr. Pasquarella, members of the Board of Education, parents, graduates, loved ones, welcome. As mayor of the city of Danbury, I am proud and honored to once again preside over the graduation of the class of 2020. And I know this is a little unusual. We really haven't had to do something like this before. But if you ask me, what is the constant that has our city always looking forward to the future with a positive view? It is this graduation ceremony that happens every year.
You see, the seniors at Danbury High School, through all of the years that I've been mayor, have been extraordinary in every way. And the class of 2020 is no different. They have been extraordinary, and they have been flexible, and they have been able to adapt to a very different environment. So today I want to congratulate the staff, the parents, and of course the graduates for a job well done. These days will pass. Each of you out there will have all kinds of challenges to face over the next several years. You, as young people, will meet those challenges, as you always have. Today, we give the gift of a nation, the gift of a city, and the gift of a state to you. And now becomes your mandate to go out and do the very best things that you can for your community, and of course, do the very best things that you can for yourself. So on behalf of all of the citizens of Danbury, I wish you God's grace, I wish you all the success, and certainly the best of luck. God bless you, and may God bless our America.
Faith Thomas will now deliver the valedictorian address.
Good day, everyone, especially to my fellow graduates. My name is Faith Thomas, and I'm privileged to be standing here in front of you all today. Some of us are here graduating with honors, while others are here feeling honored to graduate. Either way, we all made it, most of us after 4 years. As for me, I've been at Danbury High School for 6 years, but that's a speech for an entirely different day. 4 years ago, I stood on our auditorium stage, boldly addressing the Rogers Park class of 2016, saying, as a class of 2020, our vision for the future will be bright, clear, and optimistic. I genuinely thought I was being original, but then January came around, and so did the sea of 2020 vision memes. Even our yearbook theme for this year is 2020, our vision is clear. But today, I realize that this time of our lives may be the blurriest it has ever been. As Helen Keller masterfully wrote, the only thing worse than being blind is having sight, but no vision. We all had a vision of what this year would hold, the Disney trip, our robotics team at Worlds, sporting events, senior awards, festivities, and so much more. And then, on March 12th, this vision was cut short. We couldn't celebrate Pi Day with Mr. Nguyen's Calc classes and the Math Honor Society. Our annual Mr. DHS pageant was canceled. We didn't even get the chance to watch this year's production of Newsies, which I'm sure would have been amazing as always. Instead of all this, we were gifted with a plethora of new vocabulary words. Social distancing, lockdown, online learning, Zoom, and virtual spirit week. That was a new one. We all finally found ourselves getting a chance to live out our lifelong dreams, not having to go into school every day. At least, this was my dream, and I loved it at first. And then a few days passed by, and then a couple of weeks, and then we all lost track of time. And I'll admit, I actually found myself missing school, even the standstill D3 hallway. This time of quarantine quickly became a time of reflection. We only recognize the value of something when we miss it. The value of our parents and our siblings encouraging us and taking care of us. The value of our city and the leadership of Mayor Mark Boughton. The value of our school system and the efforts of Chairperson Cooper, Superintendent Pascarella, members of the Board of Education, and Mr. Donovan. The value of our diligent teachers and faculty, also our maintenance and janitorial staff, who faithfully invest into our lives and well-being every day. The value of our friends, whom we really can't live without. And the value of our beliefs, which for me is my relationship with Jesus Christ. And to all these people, we sincerely thank you. I want to thank my mom and my dad, my sisters, my grandparents, my church family, and everyone who has supported me till now. We would not have made it this far, nor can we continue onward without your help. My fellow classmates, I'm the first to admit that this is not how we wanted our life's chapter in Danbury to come to a close. It's really easy to drive on a clear sunny day, but when the weather is bad, it takes a lot more concentration and focus. And we've been thrust into the heart of a storm, fighting the invisible and praying for a brighter outcome. We are not an ordinary class that follows routine, but we are a class that continues to seize the day in spite of circumstance. The reality is, our future may always seem blurry, but the question is, are you looking at your future half full or half empty? Your future legacy depends on the lens which you view life through today. Instead of remaining blinded by life's challenges, you can choose to turn your obstacles into opportunities. We are already a living testament to this. During this new culture of shutdowns and loss, our graduation is the first event that shines a ray of light out of the darkness we all went through. Today will be remembered as a beacon of hope for the future, the first hint of a sunrise for a new day, which will only grow brighter with time. And with light comes clarity. Right now, we are mere witnesses to history, but one day, very soon, we will be the ones writing it. Today, Danbury, tomorrow, the world. Congratulations to the class of 2020. May God bless you all.
Our first student speaker, Jocelyn Villacresis, will deliver her speech.
I'd like to start by thanking the distinguished guest here today, Mayor Boughton, Board of Education Chairperson Cooper, Superintendent Pascarella, members of the Board of Education, Mr. Donovan, faculty, parents, and friends. Congratulations to the class of 2020. It's undeniable that this year will make it in the history books. 4 years ago, I would have never imagined standing here before you today. 4 months ago, I thought the same. We are the first generation to ever experience virtual senioritis, and it came with some perks. My go-to school outfit was my pajamas, my desk was now my bed, and my pencil was now a keyboard. Every day seemed like a Saturday. Although this spring was filled with uncertainty, one thing I do know is I will never complain about another Monday in the fall. We entered 2020 thinking our prom masquerade ball masks were the only mask we needed to buy. Or were we wrong? Our grandchildren will be writing DVQs in Mr. Hanbury's U.S. history class about the pandemic while he talks about the struggles he had to buy toilet paper. We waited 4 long years to be the kings and queens of the DHS castle, only to have our last spring sport games, prom, and goodbyes stripped from us. It proved just how unpredictable life can be. Whether you are excited or apprehensive about what the future holds, use the last couple of months to serve as a reassurance of all the things you are capable of accomplishing at a distance. There is no doubt that it was difficult, but with your perseverance and the support of those around you, you are now able to call yourself a graduate. Whatever you choose to do, you all have the shared experiences here at DHS that have shaped and influenced you. When we were 7, we were asked what we wanted to be when we grew up. We answered, a movie star, the president, or in my case, a dancer. But I quickly learned that my 2 left feet would make it impossible. So when they asked us again at 12, we would answer with a singer or soccer player. Now when they expect a serious answer, we are frozen in indecision, contemplating what the world will be like. Just 1 month ago, we all had it planned out. I imagined my high school career to be a straight line from start to finish, but instead it was filled with hills and valleys. Being a survivor from the mental abuse of AP Bio ignited my passion for my future studies and taught me to never wait until the day before a test to study. Sorry, Ms. Hasanovich. I could have never gotten through the rigor of the course without the help of my peers, textbook, and most importantly, crash course. The ROTC program I contemplated dropping freshman year ended up giving me a family away from home and became an integral part of my life by teaching me the skills and knowledge to be a confident leader and selfless helper. As my speech comes to a close, there are two people in particular that I'd like to thank the most, my mom and dad. As you wipe away your tears, I would like you and the audience to know that I accomplished this all for you, and I stand here proud to be your daughter. I started my education bawling my eyes out after you had left me for the first day of kindergarten, and now I leave doing the same, finishing my last day of high school. I was blessed to have you both as my support system that stood by me during my trials, tribulations, and triumphs. I love you both endlessly. Although we were challenged with a time of uncertainty, we were able to prevail and finish what we started here at DHS. Once again, congratulations. I know you are all able to turn your dreams into a reality. This is not a goodbye, but merely a see you soon. I look forward to seeing all that you accomplish.
And now, a song by the Danbury High School Madrigals.
Home, when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Home, when the water rises, you build a wall. Home, when the crowd screams out, they're screaming your name. Home, when everybody runs, you choose to stay.
Our second student speaker, Sarah Johnson, will deliver her speech, 1 in 700.
Good morning, everybody. First, I'd like to thank Mayor Boughton, Board of Education Chairperson Cooper, Superintendent Pascarella, members of the Board of Education, Mr. Donovan, faculty, parents, friends, and most importantly, the class of 2020. First of all, go us. Statistically speaking, just by graduating high school, we're officially better than 16% of the population who haven't, including Tom Cruise, so please, send me your prayers. I'd also like to start by reflecting a little on our past 4 years here together. We've come a long way since freshman year, and I won't pretend it was easy. As freshmen, we battled the mannequin challenge and clown sightings. In 2017, nearly every girl or guy participated in the Kylie Jenner lip challenge. And just a year later, we found out that there are FBI agents watching our every move through our webcams. We lucked out in 2020 so far, though. And somehow within those years, our school size has ballooned to over 3,500 students, which actually is more than the national capital of the Falkland Islands, so I thought that was pretty impressive. Congrats. So in a school of our size, I won't pretend to know all of you, and most likely, I don't know most of you. But we've shared the same roof over our heads, We remember the same cafeteria fights and drunk driving assemblies. We all anxiously stalk Mayor Boughton's Twitter page before it's supposed to snow, as we anxiously weighed whether we were going to do our homework or not last night. We're all most likely connected by friends or friends of friends or through friends of friends of friends. You get the point. But yes, we are almost 1 in 700 here, and going forward, we'll be 1 in 7 billion. But do not make the mistake of thinking that you are alone or small, or that you cannot have an impact on your community. We happen to be a powerful, passionate bunch of people who do amazing things. I've seen it firsthand during the protests after the Parkland shooting, or how we stuck together as a community during times of tragedy. I've seen us come together just as much as I've seen us express our own opinions. Now, I won't pretend that DHS is heaven, though. We're overcrowded and underfunded, and despite a lot of effort on both ends, we face a lot of problems that most other schools in our county wouldn't face. But that's taught us how to be individuals. Whether it's political or not, whether we agree with the majority or not, each one of us has a distinct voice, and that voice demands to be heard. Learning to advocate for yourself, be self-reliant, and stand up for your own beliefs is one of the most difficult things to adjust to in college, but we've been gifted with a head start. We're anything but small. We are change makers. And our class is inherently history making. I've avoided talking about the pandemic so far because it's a dark cloud over our heads. It's obvious. Things are not ideal, but it's important to recognize that we've already come together to do our part. Whether that means showing up as an essential employee, supporting healthcare workers and local businesses, or staying at home, properly social distancing, and continuing online learning. These 4 years in high school and 3 months in quarantine have truly been formative. They've built more than math or history or science. They built character and resilience and a unique ability to adapt and sacrifice in times of crisis. That's what all 700-something of us, that's what we all have in common, as diverse and different as we all are. That's what makes me so proud to say that I graduated from Danbury High School. And no offense to any of my teachers, I know math is very important, Mr. Nguyen, but that's the most important lesson I learned in high school, are values and determination. So carry that with you everywhere. Carry that lesson, make an alarm or set a reminder, whatever you gotta do. As long as we know who we are and where we're heading, we'll be okay. We'll be prepared for whatever comes our way. So go seek out success. Go further in formal education, go travel the world, go serve our beautiful country, go give back to the community. Whatever your definition of success is, go chase it. Class of 2020, I am so fortunate to have gone to high school with every single one of you. I'd wish you the best of luck, but luck isn't exactly our thing, clearly. We're not too good at it, but trust me, we won't need it anyway. Thank you.
Our principal, Mr. Donovan, will now address the faculty.
To the class of 2020, you went through one of the most difficult years in Danbury High School and high school history. But on behalf of our faculty and staff and our administration team, we wish you nothing but the best of luck in your future endeavors. And remember, once you're a Hatter, you're always a Hatter. God bless. Woo!
The class president of our 2020 graduating class, Anuma Dadzi, will now present the statement to the graduates.
Hello, class of 2020, and all of our supporters. I just want to acknowledge the gravity of what we have just accomplished. We have finally graduated. It's been a long 4 years in many of our lives, where we spent days pulling all-nighters in order to somehow miraculously pass a quiz or a test that we had spent time procrastinating over. In my case, somehow thinking that my 2 hours of studying would make up for all the days I spent neglecting my psych textbook. There were days where we spent time getting to know our peers in order to really understand the people who sat in the seats around us. We would all sit and imagine our senior year, thinking about how great it would be to experience the last week of high school, and best of all, graduation. That it approached very fast and definitely did not go how we imagined it would in our heads. Regardless, we are leaving Danbury High School now, and even if you don't want to admit it, this school has become a sort of second home to all of us. From Monday to Friday, we inhabited its halls, and all 3,300 students' faces became familiar. We all became main characters in this movie. Right now, we are making history. Sure, it is against our will, and Corona has caused dysfunction in our lives and has plunged many into tragedy, but we are making history nonetheless. I know that this won't be the last time we, the class of 2020, will be able to do such a thing. The future is ours. We are the faces that will be seen in the White House years from now, sitting in Congress, or even becoming well-renowned artists, activists, inventors, humanitarians, and the list goes on. We as a class hold the ability to fight for what we know is ours, ranging from a healthy planet to what we believe is right in general. Throughout these 4 years, we have managed to create communities that integrated different friend groups and people, be it in our class group chats or just sitting together at lunch. DHS, through its inclusion of many different people, allowed us to experience things that neighboring schools could not. It allowed us the opportunity to view the gray in the world and not just the black and white. Walking in the hallways of Danbury High School exposed us to multiple different languages, giving us the ability to engage in many different cultures as well as many different people. A tool that will definitely be useful throughout our lives. We all have been given the opportunity to better understand who we are as human beings. And in a sense, being in an environment like Danbury High School, which welcomed many different types of people, is to thank for that. Sometimes while watching TV shows or movies based on high school, I find myself criticizing the content, claiming that high school isn't like that. When scenes of bullying due to race or sexuality or religion, or just basic nerd versus popular kid tropes appear. But I have come to realize that in other places, that is a reality. And we thankfully weren't dealt that card because we attended Danbury High School. As a black woman who is also a member of the LGBT community, many of these films or TV shows depict people with portions of my identities, if not all, as someone who isn't of importance or someone to be taunted or not taken seriously. But as I stand here before you all as senior class president at our graduation, it is clear that sort of high school experience couldn't be reality at DHS, where I have been given the opportunity to be myself, express my opinions without fears, and just excel in every meaning of the word. We have gone through many historical events together, with a chance to experience many highs as well as the lows that come along with it. And through it all, we have managed to make it here. In the midst of us experiencing yet another one, I want to provide the message that this too shall pass. And we, the class of 2020, will only gain more knowledge and achieve greater things. Congratulations as well as thank you, class of 2020. And I wish you all a lifetime of success.
And now, the chair of the Board of Education, Chairperson Cooper.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. To our mayor, Mark Boughton, Dr. Sal Pasquarella, Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Kevin Warston, Assistant Superintendent of Schools, and the principal of Danbury High School, Mr. Dan Dunham. This is a great school, and I know the students that have attended the school can agree with me that they have great staff, they have great leadership, and again, they have made it up until now. Most of all, thank your parents for your support. Thanks to everyone who made today possible. As you leave Danbury High School, please remember the great things that you were taught started in kindergarten through 12th that made you the special person you are today. No matter what you do or go, be safe, respect yourself, respect your parents, and always reach for the stars. Congratulations to the class of 2020 from the Danbury Board of Education.
I would like to welcome Superintendent Pasquarella to say a few words.
Congratulations, members of the class of 2020. I'm Dr. Sal Pasquarella, Superintendent of Danbury Public Schools. First, on behalf of the Board of Education, thank you. We are proud of every graduate. Each of you focused on what needed to be done and finished high school under tremendous uncertainty and enormous change. You should be very proud of yourself. These are unique times, and you were asked to make huge sacrifices. You had to give up certain rites of passage that are an important part of transitioning from high school student to an adult. However, the circumstance that changed your immediate future happened quickly, and the world was not prepared for the magnitude of the disruption. The fact that you stayed the course and finished your education speaks volumes of the men and women you have become. St. Francis of Assisi once said, "Start by doing what's necessary, then do what's possible, and suddenly you're doing the impossible." I'm sure in March, as we left Danbury High School for online learning and the virtual classroom, many of you thought finishing school seemed impossible. But you started by doing what was necessary and what was possible. And then, a few months later, here you are, ready to receive your high school diploma. You did what seemed to be the impossible. While at Danbury High School, you led the state with many of your accomplishments, from dominating state sports to building award-winning robots and to getting accepted into some of the nation's finest universities. This commitment to yourselves and your community and of doing the right things will be the key to your future. I've seen firsthand the outpouring of caring and concern from Danbury High School students. It is part of the culture of your school and is now as much a part of you as everything else you have learned and mastered at Danbury High School. Don't underestimate the power of helping others in times of crisis or reaching out when you need help. This sense of community will empower you throughout your lives. You have proved, especially in recent months, that you are giving. When you were called upon, some of you helped with food drives, while others helped deliver groceries to the elderly. Some of you stayed home and cared for younger siblings while mom and dad worked. Others of you comforted classmates coping with isolation. While at Danbury High School, you were prepared for these kinds of services in addition to your academic rigors. And when you were called into action, you responded without hesitation. Our school community has benefited from your service and your commitment to finishing school. I know these times seem uncertain, and maybe you're not sure what to expect when fall comes. Will you find a job? Will you go away to school? Will your life take place online? When will you see your friends? These are difficult questions to answer, and the uncertainty may be unsettling. But you need to know that you are better prepared than you may realize to go forward in the face of all these challenges and adversities. More importantly, you are part of something bigger because we all connected to each other. We are here to help each other, and you have lived that to a great degree this year. It will be one of the most important lessons you will take throughout your lifetime. Remember, good things happen all around you, every day. As St. Francis said, do what you need to do, and then do what's possible. Eventually, you will see that what you have thought was impossible was within your reach. Good things will happen all around you. You have proven that you have the preservation and perseverance and the drive to be successful, to make sacrifices and to help others. In a lot of ways, we have learned to embrace what is really important. Helping our neighbors, being closer to our friends and family, spending time reflecting and appreciation of nature and solitude. Our lives will eventually return to normal, but you have changed. We have all changed. You have become more resilient and more determined. You have become more compassionate and more thoughtful. You also are changed in that you realize, even though today is not filled with parties and celebration, it is a beautiful day that marks the end of a difficult journey, but the beginning of a new one that you will approach with strength and confidence. Class of 2020, congratulations.
And now, the moment we've been waiting for and worked so hard for, the presentation of diplomas.
Peter Alonso.
Jordan Augusto. Jorfi Abreu. Ashley Amagon. Pedro Almeida. Carlos Alvarez. Victor Alvarez Raybon. Talia Albano. Gabriel Alvin. Samuel Alam. Katrina Andino.
Thank you.
Tanya Alfaro. Almeida. Regine Ahmed.
Good job. Good job. Let's trade.
Straight ahead of Dr. Roman. Kevin Albela. Julia Andrade. Ernest Almonte. Victoria Amaro.
Julia, stand right here.
Tanya Alvarez. Carolina Al. Andrew Alfidi. Nicholas Alfidi. Jason Alfidi. Crystal Acosta. Ismael Adame.
Rebecca Anderson. Dante Adamson. Betsy Ante Domenico. Jasir Adjanoski. Natalie Alvarez. Aaliyah Alonso. Tiana Anderson. Joshua Akuamoa. Zach Richard Akuamoa. Emmanuel Akuamoa. Christian Barreto. Brandon Arevalo. Quinn Banks. Ronnie Beltran. Anna Bakulima Duran. Mark Arpey. Ashley Bermeo. Andres Bever. Arta Barisha. Michaela Beer. Brian Iavaca. Spencer Barnett. Jason Arias. John Bennett. Juliana Asher. Jose Avila Campos. Leslie Arias. Evan Beck. Michael Arujo. Mark Atariguana. Gustavo Ataize. Evelyn Iavaca. Sarah Barta. Jonathan Barreto. Anangel Aracena. Madeline Beckham. Naya Blackwood. Cole Blankshin. Spencer Blasberg. Mariana Bankhart. Jackson Benz. G. Edward Bell. Anna Baxter. Maricel Castillo. Dave Cabrera Palacios. Nicole Carpio Yunga, Stephanie Kaba, Shanice Brown, Lizeth Baradas, Natalie Cabrera Vasquez, Brenda Brito, Hector Capellan, Nino Bueno, Katie Catalano, Crystal Calderon,
Michelle Carreno, Luis Calle, Anita Castro Zinnen, Dean Bortsev, Aiden Byrne, Jacqueline Briganza, Lindsay Butera, Jeriel Castillo, Kristen Castro, Katia Cardoso, Aiden Castricone, Catherine Cardenas, Sarah Carlson, Junior Castro, Nixon Cando, Carol Cabrera, Braden Callahan, Kirk Carr, Joanna Caceres, Christian Carlos, Jared Cartas, Rander Cabrera Pizantes, Kiana Bird, Hannah Burgess, Daniela Caiza Andrango, Jaden Cazorla, Christine Cladera, Yocasta Chacon, Jaden Cook, Dennis Cooney, Emily Clifford, Audrey Clifford, Andre Charles, Fernando Costa, Wei Chen, Melanie Cornell, Rylando Chambers, Christian Cornell, Eric Civitella, Alexis Chicazier, Freddie Centeno, Samantha Chim, Aiden Coleman, Emilio Cheeks, Pedro Cherez, Edwin Chacon, Brian Chavla, Luca Constancio. Theodore Cote. Stephanie Costa. Ben Cola Darcy. Connor Corcoran. Angel Cepeda. Angel Cepeda. Claire Coffey. Nicholas Coelho. Alexandra Chakar. Joseph Chimbo. Dennis Chavez. Corey Conley. Larissa Costa. Lorena Costa. McKenna Cook. Jovangel Colon. Jennifer Diaz Benitez. Jaira Cruz. Jamar Crawford. Gloria Dixon. Abigail Craig. Delinas Diaz. Gustavo Da Fonseca. Jennifer Crespo. Bianca D'Souza. Santiago Delgado Sue. Michael Cunningham. Marie Cunningham. Dianara Cruz. Emma D'Ascencio. Gabriel De Lima. Jonathan De Silva. Edwarlin Cruz Cruz. Lorraine De Silva. Gabriela Cuenca. Tiago De Silva. Marcus De Silva. Matthew Cura. Tanisha Cunningham. Michael Kushnick. Delaney Dempster. Michael Cruz. Lauren Curry. Anna Dela Cruz. Enuma Dadzi. Elijah Crayon. Olivia DeMora. Bernie Dela Cruz. Tiana Davis. Tito Davis. Gabriel DeBrito. Dante Downing. Zachary Domingos. Jalen Dixon. Tiffany Domain. Tiffany Ferreira. Ilona Fury. Destiny Douglas. Kevin Estevam. Mateus Dos Reyes. Joanna Farias Rivera. Ruben Espinal. Shirley Duck. Oriana Foss. Olivia Escalera. Richard Dos Santos. Eric Dubkowski. Madison Doobie. Sophia Folino. Gary Fernandez. Jana Fajardo. Jake Ferrandino. Luis Espinal. Annabelle Fallis. Samuel Espinal. Isabella Dos Santos. Daryl Estevez. Joseph Draper. Adam Fox. Valerie Fox. Colin Fuentes. Isaiah Easter. Dana Elcori. Jacqueline Falcone. Loisha Espinal Bautista. Evelyn Duran Maldonado.
Ashley Garcia Leva. Keisha Pacheco. Wendoli Granados. Aiden Johnston. Jack Pompilio. Jessica Posmentier. Jacob Gamp. Sierra Pittman. Kaylee Gallego. Gendry Padilla. Milena Gomes. Jonathan Pani Ordonez. Erica Garcia Morquecho. Tyler Party. Maria Luisa Gregorio. Marcus Jerez Papalia. Jesse Patton. John Garcia. Jacob Green. Jenny Pinnett. Elizabeth Galiza. Jennifer Pereira. Gabriela Pernas. Lena Gonzalez. Emelise Garza. Brian Pacheco. Lucas Jeffrion. Brandon Pia.
Angelo Palma. Gabriela Galarza. Anthony Garcia. Bianca Pereira. Vita Concalves. John Para Rodriguez. Rashmi Pai. Mia Gregory. Ashley Georgie. Abraham Patino. Dennis Patino. Diana Gonzalez. Connor Perel. Priscilla Garcia. But Sally Garcia. Kevin Pina. Breno Paez. Lancy Garados. Shirley Alexandra Perez. Jason Gonzalez. Nayana Perkins. Antoine Goldson. Steven Gonzalez Neary. Johanna Piedra. Jessica Glowacki. Ashley Janelle. Lizeth Pawnee. Christian Gardecki.
Stephanie Perez Guerra. Carol Granda. Samantha Perez. Michelle Posadas. Roberto Pena Jara. Kelwin Pinheiro. Smriti Puvanan. Igor Pereira. Juan Peralta Espinal. John Pasha. Alvier Rodriguez. Washington Mendieta. Manny Guaman. Jenna Haddad. Charlize Rodriguez. Kiara Hammond. Cameron Hilliard. AJ Quinn. Oscar Rodas. Hannah Hodgson. Brisa Rodriguez. Joshua Hirsch. Matthew Henry. Megan Ressa. Anthony Hernandez. Gabriella Paca Ribeiro. Harvin Ramirez. Bruno Guzman. Malachi Hopkins. Carissa Robertson. Emily Hernandez. Cameron Racino. Emmanuel Guaman. Luis Joshua Presnell. Brianna Robertson. Saray Gunter. Prem Joshwant Rana. Katie Guaman.
Isabel Prudhomme.
Joao Guedes. Nandika Puri. Jacob Heffley. Yesenia Rodriguez. Alexander Halpin. Abigail Gumpright. Jorge Guerrero. Kayla Hodge. Azariah Rangel. Rodney Robledo. Edel Hernandez. Ricardo Guadalupe. Omar Gauchun. Jennifer Reyes. Anastasia Herzegovich. Haley Queroz. David Gann. Leticia Rodriguez. Evelyn Herrera. Alexander Riofrio. Luke Hickey. Paul Hickey. Diamond Pride. Braylon Hernandez. Kyle Jackson. Liliana Rodriguez. Jalia Reyes. Damian Priano. Kiana Hay. Ashley Gimoris Lima. Mega Rana. Delvin Jesus Rodriguez. Grace Rudick. Juwil Hernandez.
Ivan Espinal. Miranda Pughes.
Sophia Finn Robles. Barney Rahman. John Rodriguez Galarza. Jessica Kairas. Iman Ramzan.
David Sanchez. Elissa Jasmine. Linda Saad. Omar Saad. Eleazar Jimenez. Diana Salazar. Neandra Sanchez. Angela Saquinala. Edmund Hurdle. Shannon Harris. Nicole Salas Aguilar. Ethan Hendricks. Carolina Sanongo. Brittany Jimenez. Christian Robert Salas. Michael Kazicki. Genesis Michelle Rousseau. Clever Adrian Salinas Vargas. Gerard Kane. Kevin Jimenez. Yasmin Santos. Alyssa Jack. Ryan Jack. Randall Sayers. Tyler Johnson. Lisbeth Salazar. Melissa Jimenez. Kimberly Rosado. Linda Heumeyer. Kelly Sari. Sarah Johnson. Jefferson Salazar. Anjali Joseph. Alexander Saliski. Alicia Jacobs. Samuel Rosas. Storm Jacobs. Abigail Salka. Branelli Rosario Acevedo. Aaliyah Hawk. Kayla Santana. Stephanie Jaron. Christian Romero. Sarah Huang. Amelia Aria Sam. Leia Istanbuli. Isaiah Sawyer. Christine Sangfit. Kylie Holt. Sally Romero. Claribel Ipina. Robert Ivansko. Daniel Rubin. Aaliyah Jones. Elvis San Martin. Basel Kasim. Benjamin Sholkoff. Janae Jolly. Anthony Salinas. Jessica Rosario. Anaya Sapp. Alexander Gibson. Alicia Eve Sweeney. Clarissa Lugo Commons. Alexander Cease. Larissa Late. Michael Sturgis. Caden Lozada. Eddie Solis. Namar Lara Marte. Shane Simmons. Victoria Lobo. Viviana Lopez Ramirez. Samantha Lassen. Edwin Lopez Salazar. Joseph Stefanelli. Jessup Lohano. Kushi S. Sukaria. Lindsay Kirkness. Brooke Kuhn. Diana Seguenza. Riley Litwin. John Sigua. Adeline Lotley. Brianna Elaine Santana. Michael Lau. Wesley Shook. Michelle Siancas. Asia Landry. Danielle Loriano. Dylan Rosemark. Kelly Lascarain. John Seguenza. Sangeeta Kuchibola. Laura Snow. Brianna Lewis. Gabriella Lopes. Leticia Silva. Lauren Stewart. Linda Lopez Panaranda. Alec Neil Stanton. Erica Cromer. Shomo Sichter. Maria Khan. Romeo Late. Kyrie Keo. Alton Spencer. Luke Leffelbein. Jasmine Stone. Bradley Kerr. Danae Sherman. Brian Sequillo. Reed Lyle. Jackson Lyle. Christopher Sherman. Jay Silva. Alexander Lopez Valenzuela. Jorbel Lara Delgado. Amish Sony. Andrew Lewis. Bridget Silva. Natalia Luciana Castillo. Krupa Sony. Logan Cocott. Cody J. Seguenza. Najwan Lindo. Steven Suarez. Maylee Cree. Kaylee Del Carmen Seguenza. Vanessa Sin. Laura Silva. Andrew Simmons. Anna Lee Spaulding. Lizzie Valencia. Lisbeth Marca. Eric Tomei. Daisy Caroline Maida. Jonathan Vasquez. Sarah Marks. Shamara Marks. Leonardo Marin. Lodi Tavares. Daniela Tavares. Alina Martinez. Keith Touche. Chantel Marin. Kevin Alexander Tenasaka. Charlie McKinsella. Brian Vargas. Mayeli Vargas. Hannah Crate. Michael Vasquez. Michelle Vasquez. Carla Mendez. Jordan Toribio. Matthew Valdivieso. Elder Marcos Asensio. Elvis Fernando Tenacata. Emma McNevin. Roshni Vasudevan. Aaron Melendez. Chris Tavares. Matthew Martin. Annalise Tuno. Alexander Medina. Nayeli Vasquez. Joshua Martinick. Javier Urena Peralta. Molly Mitchell. Christian Verduga. Daniel McInsella. Sahad Hassan. Kalisha Marquez. Faith Thomas. Jacob Metzinger. Tim Maroof. Jalisa Taneo. Lisbeth Nunez. Brandon Tysia. Catherine Martinez Perez. Jolie Maxwell. Mary Elizabeth Mead. Darwin Tenacella. Michael Torres. Charlie Tenesaka. Alexander Meist. James McKellars. Melissa Vasquez Barradas. Osvaldo Mendez. Jolie Trin. Catherine Vasquez. Natalie Matthews. Ariel Tenesaka. Jordan Thomas. Devin Tomas. Precious McCray. Michael Vasquez. Cameron Tate. Mariah Millman. Jordan Macias. Abel Urena. Kyla Menz. Karen Vacancella. Dejanelle Mellon. Ende Tall. Paul Vejo Andrade. Caitlin Van Tronk. Alexander Voss. Sebastian Vega. Liam Waldron. Claire Moreira. Joao Nunez. Dariani Villar. Janelle Muniz. Yadira Nunez. Jose Montero. Samuel Wolf Anderson. Mia Ortiz. Cindy Yauri. Donika Nutsulai. Dava Nutsulai. Devin Webb. Fernando Moranta. Juliana Venegas. Waleed Mohammed. Blessing Ferras. Carl Ormsby. Kayla Morais. Allison Vecchia Spooner. Matthew Moreno. Joseph Mooney. Jocelyn Villacresis. William O'Rourke. Brianna Snipe. Nilla Narayan. Catherine Viveros. Jack Daniel Watson. Kelly Ochoa. Grace Wiltsey. Judy Nguyen. Brendan Walsh. Brian Janez. Alexis Ortega Gonzalez. Caroline Noel Williams. Paris Ortiz Torres. Michael Walsh. Jennifer Moran. Jadira Orby. Kimberlyn Vega. Jimena Yunga. Louis Monroy. Mike Nolagari. Aaron Wilshire. George Morales. Jyotsna Vijay Ura Gavandra. Victor Oliveira. Tyler Warren. Audrey Velez. Emily Hallis. Humaira Mufti. Robert Yastrzemski. Claudia Nieves Rios. Kelly Villa. Jeremiah David Whitaker. James O'Donnell. Roan Winter Jr. Jeffrey Osborne. Vincent Shea. Erica Yunga Cuito. Evelyn Vidal Manzano. Xavier Yanza Centeno. Gary Zhang. Jairus Watson. Jaira Watson.
To the class of 2020, you went through one of the most difficult years in Danbury High School and high school history. But on behalf of our faculty and staff and our administration team, we wish you nothing but the best of luck in your future endeavors. And remember, once you're a Hatter, you're always a Hatter. God bless. Woo!